people, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Tatiana. How are you all doing? I hope you're all taking care of yourselves and you're keeping well and being kind to one another. So if today's your first time coming across my YouTube channel, I want to say thank you and welcome. And if you already subscribe to my channel, thank you for coming back also. So we all know why we're here, so let's get into the video. Okay, so today I'm sharing my journey of how I became a professional artist in a month. Yes, I did. And here is how it all happened. So just a little backstory. While I was at high school, I did art as part of my, as part of the curriculum. It was just part of the curriculum. I didn't think anything of it. Skip forward, studied 2018. I was doing my fashion degree course at Buckinghamshire. That was going well. I completed my first year, and I actually completed my first year all by using my Samsung Galaxy phone. The reason for me saying that is because I was a full-time mom. I was living outside of London, not near my family, so childcare became an issue, and meaning that I always had to leave uni early and staying up late working on my phone so I could submit my portfolio in time with everybody else, and I did that and was able to complete my first year. And as I entered my second year, it's a bit difficult to even talk about it right now, because during my second year, I was all pumped up, things were going really, really well. I was like the example of, the lecturers would direct the students to come to me for advice, and they would use my work as an inspiration and stuff like that. So being, circumstances beyond my control, or cared, and unfortunately I was unable to complete my second year, and that was like the hardest time of my life. I was devastated, y'all. I was so devastated. I felt like my whole world had just shattered, like had just come crumbling down before me, and I felt like I had lost myself. I had lost who Tatiana was, because at the time I felt like fashion was me, like me doing this course was my purpose in life. So when that got taken away, I just didn't know who I was anymore. And to skip forward, the pandemic hit in January, and I came down to London to visit my brother, and we're just having a conversation about life, as we always do. And I think some business topics came up, and he was referring to a guy on YouTube. He's called Humble Penny. So he was referring to his videos and how inspiring they are, and he made mention that, oh, you can actually, he said some people are actually turning their artwork into businesses, like full-time businesses. I was like, oh, really? So, I mean, at the time when he said it, I wasn't thinking about turning my work into a business. I just said, okay, well, are you talking about this type of work? So I pulled up my phone and showed him some of my artwork, and he was just blown away. Like, wow, like you have this work just sitting on your phone and you're not doing anything with it. And I was like, well, what am I supposed to do with it? Like, I was not thinking making money off of my work. So with that said, I came back, and I had a, he had boosted up my confidence so much on, what I could do. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna work on it. So I remember having an Instagram page at the time when I was at uni. So I actually changed that from personal to business. I started uploading work that was just sitting on the phone, and just to kind of get the vibes, just to kind of see what it feels like if I was gonna potentially turn my artwork into a business, and to see how people felt about my work. So I did that, and to skip forward, I think it was after I spoke with him, I actually came across a post on Instagram about Black Pound Day that was taking place on the 5th of September. So This was, I think this was ending of August, heading into the first week of September, and I went ahead and bought my ticket. I said I'm gonna just take the work that I have on my phone because the work was already done, right? So all I needed to do was just get a printer. All right, I'm just like, I have these digital prints that I'm going to take with me. And no, that was not what God had planned for me. So me and my brother went to the store. He purchased a brand new printer for me. This was not the printer that I wanted, but that's all they had in the store because this was during the pandemic. So I had to just grab that printer, came home, trying to set it up. Even trying to set it up was hard because it was a wireless printer that you had to connect to your phone and it was just not connecting. Oh, it was just a mess, right? So then the printer eventually worked and I was able to print out one of the digital artwork that I have on my phone. And the quality, I was like, oh my God, no, like I can't possibly take this to an exhibition. It's just not gonna cut it. Like I wasn't satisfied with it. There's no way other people were gonna be happy with it, right? So I tried a couple more and still wasn't happy. And eventually the printer even stopped working completely. So y'all, can you imagine like this printer that I had put all my hopes in, right? It's just completely failed me. And I remember my brother and a very good friend of mine telling me, T, you should really try exploring. As an artist, you should really, try and do other things other than digital, because not everybody likes digital. You should try and do some painting. And they started pulling up paint, other paint, artist paint work and showing it to me. And I remember being so offended, like, how dare you? How dare you tell me not to do what I'm good at and to do something else, which was the opposite of what they were trying to do. So, I mean, I was offended. Like I just said to myself, this is what I'm good at. I'm good at this thing, which is what we normally do, right? I'm good at this thing. This is what I'm gonna subject myself to. I've limited myself into this box. This is where I'm staying. I'm not coming out of the box, But they were trying to help me out. So when the printer failed me, God was like, okay, well, what you gonna do now? You've put all your hopes and dreams into that thing, and then it fails you. So what do you do? So I literally, just went to the store and purchased canvases and paint brushes, acrylic paint, oil paint, like the whole shebang. It was time to experiment. It was time to prove to myself that I was really an artist. I mean, I wasn't trying to prove anything to anybody, but I just wanted to prove to myself that I could actually do something other than just the digital, because that's all I was used to. At uni, I painted some swatches and added it to my portfolio, but I wasn't going to call myself an artist. Far from that, but wow, it was just so amazing, guys. Like the fact that I came home and the first thing I drew was, I think it was an elephant. I drew an elephant and I painted it. I'm gonna try and see if I can find it and put it in a slide somewhere. And I drew the elephant and I was like, okay, I could see something happening here. Now, because I hadn't found my niche at the time, as an artist, because there's so many different types of artists, I had to find who I was as an artist. I hadn't found it yet. So I was doing all types of painting and I blew my own socks off because I was like, wow, like I knew I've always been a creative person. I'm a visionary person. I love to explore, but I just didn't realize I could actually paint if I had put my mind to it. And I ended up enjoying the painting more than even the digital work. Like I literally just found it so therapeutic. I would just pick up my paintbrush and just stroking away. Then I have my instrumentals in the background and I just paint and paint and paint. I'll take my daughter to school. I'll come home. I will paint. I will stay up till 3 in the morning painting. And y'all, by the time when it was time to exhibit my work, by the time the 3rd of October came, I was able to have literally have about over 40 pieces of artwork that I was going to exhibit at the exhibition. So that is my story. That is literally what happened. So I say all this and I share this with you all to really encourage you. If there's any giftings on the inside, you might never know what it is until you just try it. Just do it. The Bible says, whatever your hands find to do, do it and do it well. You know, I think sometimes in life, we put so much emphasis on just one thing, and when that thing fails us, we become shattered. You know, we feel like our whole world has ended because we didn't try to do other things. And I believe that we're all gifted and talented in our own ways, and sometimes it might just be that one thing that you're good at, but we can also explore. You know, we can't just put all our eggs in one basket. But yes, y'all, that brings me to the end of this story. I just want to encourage each and every one of you, don't give up on your hopes and dreams. Don't give up on your talents. I always say in my posts, don't sleep on your talents. Whatever they are, as trivial as you may think they are, God has a way of turning. God has a way of just, you know, turning things that we found difficult or things that we find to be whatever into beautiful things. Like the Bible says, he makes all things beautiful in his time. Right? In his time. So had I decided to just give up because the printer gave up on me, then I would not be sitting here as a professional artist. And I'm going to do another episode going into detailing more about my Black Power Day exhibition. So make sure to come back to watch that video. I want to say, if you've made it this far to my story, thank you. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you were blessed by this video, by anyhow, even if I made you laugh, even if you were inspired by anything that I said, even if you're currently going through something similar to what I went through, give this video a thumbs up, put it in the comment section, and let's communicate, let's build each other up, let's uplift each other, and I hope my story can inspire somebody out there. If you were blessed by this video, don't also forget to share it with somebody else who it might be a blessing to. All right, guys, so until my next video, thank you, take care, God bless, and do what you love and love what you do. All right, bye. Bye, guys.